Got it. You get it.
Hey everybody, Sean James here from My Self Reliance. Callie is a little bit restless this morning. She's going to be attacking me and bringing. She wants me to keep throwing the dummy for her. Anyway, if you're fairly new to the channel and you've just been here watching the cabin videos, you might not have noticed or might not have watched any of my outdoor trip videos. A lot of the time when I'm not working around the house or building a cabin or living outside, I'm actually on canoe trips and fishing trips and hunting trips around Ontario, Canada. So I'm always in bear territory from where my house is to where the property is and the cabin that I'm building and all the trips that I go on all over Ontario. There's bears everywhere I go. We always have to deal with potential bear issues, and when it comes to storing our food, it's essential that we keep that we protect our food for one thing, but also that we don't create habituated bears that get used to eating food from humans. So we want to make sure that they don't ever get rewarded for raiding a camp and coming across our food storage and getting into it. So one of the solutions that I really like, actually the primary solution that I've been using for the last 3 years now, is the Ursac. But when I was telling the owner of Ursac, who lives in California, that we were doing this trip, he was kind enough to send us three new bags to take out with us. So what he sent us, anyway, Tom is the owner, and what he sent Joe and I is three new bags. So this is the all white, the S29, I believe it's called. I've been using this one specifically for 3 years without a liner. Never had a problem. I did have that one bear encounter where a big bear tried to rip it off the tree unsuccessfully. Never had little critters get into this, so I've been very happy with it. How it works is that you just tie that, put a double overhand knot in there, then you tie that to a tree, and that's it. The bears can't get into that. If they pull on that, they just pull it tighter. I put a lock sack, basically Ziploc bag inside that, which is a scent-proof bag, and I can store 7 days worth of dehydrated food in that. So, sent this two of the S29s, great bag, like I said, that's the one I've been using. And then this new version, it's called the Almighty, I believe. Yeah, the Ursac Almighty. So what they've done is they've had some issues with smaller animals getting their teeth through this bag. So what they've done is they've lined the bag with another lamination, another fabric inside. So it's got the Spectra fabric on the outside and then a puncture resistant Kevlar liner on the inside. So you can see this. So the bag looks bigger. I think it's the same volume, holds the same amount of food. And that Velcro is closed, and then you cinch that so it's double the closure. But inside you see this yellow membrane, and that's a solid sort of water resistant material that smaller animals can't get their teeth through. So Velcro that closed, cinch it up again, tie it to the tree. Fantastic system. So I highly recommend this. So thank you, Tom, that was very much appreciated. We will be able to fit 10 days worth of food for two guys in those three bags, no problem. We'll have a bag each with our regular food items that for each of us individually, and then we'll have a common bag probably for like some fish spices and oil for cooking fish and things like that. So quick video, like I said, appreciate you following along. I will get I'll get some more longer videos out shortly, but I'm gonna do a few gear videos. I've got a bunch of new gear and a bunch of old gear that I just want to go over for this upcoming 10-day trip in the boreal forest. It's gonna be a little more challenging than some of the other trips you've seen me do, so I'm gonna need a really good, secure, bomb-proof gear setup. So thanks again for watching, guys. Really appreciate it, and look forward to seeing you in the next video.